Hi everyone, welcome back to another video. In this video, I will show you the quickest and easiest way to set up Moodle on your Windows PC. I'm currently running Windows 11 on my PC, so open any one of your search engines. I'm using Google Chrome. Type in Moodle, press Enter on your keyboard, and it's usually the first link. It's moodle.org. You click on that link and it will open the moodle.org homepage. Okay, click on the download Moodle LMS4, and then you will be presented with this page here. You'll see two bullets. The first one is the Mac OS installation, and the second one is the Windows installation. So I'll right click on that one, and then I'll download Moodle 4.5.1, this one here. So I'll click on download the zip folder. It will start downloading to my downloads folder, so I can specify where it needs to download. I'll click on save, and then it will start downloading. Once it's done downloading, I'll just click on the folder icon there. It will take me to my downloads folder. I'll then right click on that folder and then open with WinRAR. I'm using WinRAR. You can use 7-zip or WinZip, whichever way you choose. I'll click on that. I'll then extract the folders to my downloads folder. I'll click on OK here, and it will start the extraction process. Once it's done, you can close this window and then open the folder. You'll now see there's a README file, a start-moodle.exe, a stop-moodle.exe, and then a server folder. Let's click on the readme.txt. It opens, and then you can read through it. It says here that how to use it. You can run start-moodle.exe to start the system, and then you can visit the HTTP localhost. Usually what I'll do is I'll copy this, and then I'll minimize this, and then I'll double click on start-moodle.exe. I'll just minimize that, and we're back on our browser. I'll open a new tab. I'll paste the localhost, and there you'll see my Moodle installation is starting. Okay. We can choose the language here. Okay, so I'll leave it on English. So I'll click on next here. And then I'll leave everything on its default here. Okay, so you can specify if you want to save the download, the Windows installer to, let's say, your desktop. You can specify the desktop and this will state desktop. If you want to save it in your C drive, you can specify your C drive. I'll leave it in my downloads folder, or in my downloads folder, I'll click on next. It will then ask me for these. I'll leave it as is, everything as is, and then I'll click on next. So it's asking me to continue with the installation. I'm just agreeing and continuing. Now it's starting the installation process. It says here that your server environment meets all minimum requirements. I'll click on continue. It's now installing everything. You'll see there from the plugins to the activities to the modules to the blocks to the filters, course formats, reports. So the installation process might take some time depending on your system. Okay, so it's done. You can click on continue. And that's it. Now you need to provide a username as well as a password. So let's type in a password. So there's my password, and then you can change the name, you can change the last name, the first name, as well as the email address. So I'll just type in an email address. I'll scroll down and I'll click on update profile. So just remember your password, okay? I'll scroll down and I'll click on update profile. You can specify your site's name. And then you can specify a short name, and then you can provide a description. You can change these default settings, but I'll leave it for now. And then you need to specify an outgoing email address or mail configuration. So I'll just leave it blank and I'll click Save Changes. And now it asks me for a support email. I'll just provide a support email. I'll click on Save Changes. And there we have it. The model is installed. Let's just go to site administration, notifications. And you'll see that we've installed Moodle 4.5.1 on our Windows PC. As easy as that. You can go to your homepage and now you can start building your Moodle site. Now that we've installed Moodle, the first thing we need to do is increase the file upload size. So let's go to site administration. I'll scroll down to where it says security and then click on site security settings. If you scroll down, you'll see the maximum upload file size. It's currently on 32 megabytes. You want to increase this size since you will be uploading files, plugins, and so forth that are larger than 32 megabytes. Okay, so how do we do that? Remember, it's currently on the maximum size is 32 megabytes. Okay, so let's go to our folder. I'll go to my installation folder, my Moodle Windows installer folder. Okay, then I'll first stop my services by double clicking on stopmoodle.exe. I'll then wait a few seconds. So it's currently stopping my server XAMPP services. You can press continue. Okay, it's stopped now. Now double click on the server folder and then in the PHP folder, double click and then find the php.ini file. Just right click on it, open with Notepad, and here we are. Okay, so if you press Control and F on your keyboard, you'll see that you can now search for files. So search for the file upload max file size. Okay, so search for this file and you'll see that the maximum upload file size is 32 megabytes. So usually I'll change the post max as well as the file upload size. So let's make this 512. And let's make this 512 as well. Okay. I'll usually change the max input files as well. It's currently 1000, but I'll leave it for now. Okay. So then click on file and then save. Then close this. Go back. And then we need to start the Moodle services again. Okay. Or the server services. Okay. So let's double click on start moodle.exe. Let's wait a few seconds. Okay, so there it's started. And now we can go to our localhost again. You can just refresh Moodle. So immediately you'll see that the max uploads file size is now 512 the maximum size. Okay, so now you can start uploading files. Okay.